How's about cooking something up with me? Hey, hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe we could find us a brand new recipe?
Welcome. Welcome to Country Kitchen. You know, we've been doing this show, this is our sixth year, and we've had a couple of living legends, and today we have a great one. Little Jimmy Dickens.
Hey, thank you very much.
I mean that.
Thank you, man.
What?
That's nice.
I mean, you have spanned at least 5 decades in this business, haven't
I've
you?
I've loved every minute of it.
How did you get started?
Oh, I don't know. In West Virginia, when I was a kid in high school, and I thought that I just wanted to be a professional entertainer and worked on that and took little jobs in radio stations in different areas of the country. And Mr. Acuff brought me here in 48. So,
isn't that something?
And I've been here since.
You just can't hold a job, can you, Jimmy? Were you born with a voice that big? I mean, he has a huge voice.
Oh, well, I don't know about that. I never claimed to be a singer much. But
you're kidding me.
No, I never did. But I've worked hard all my life and still work at it at being an entertainer, and I try hard.
Well, I think you have to. If you care about what you're doing, I bet each performance is important to you, right?
I love it.
Yeah.
I love every bit of it.
I just couldn't help but notice all this beautiful jewelry you have, too. Wow.
Well, thank you, ma'am. Three or four more payments, and I'll own all that.
Well, I'm so thrilled because Jimmy today, you know, they call him Tater. For short, right?
Right, yeah.
For short, no pun intended. But he's going to make for us tater top meatloaf. So you come back with little Jimmy Dickens, okay? Welcome back. Before we get started today with little Jimmy Dickens' tater top meatloaf, I dressed in your honor, sir. I noticed this gorgeous gold anchor on his neck, and I wore my little military jacket.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
And I wore it really because I was reading all about your distinguished career and all your travels for our servicemen.
Yes, I've done a lot of that. I've been overseas many, many times. We went to Europe about 13 times.
Isn't that
all over Europe for the American military, and then made 3 trips to Vietnam during that crisis and made 1 complete trip around the world.
That's amazing. God bless you. Well, I'm sure you've eaten everything under the sun.
Yeah.
today we're going to have tater top meatloaf. So
tater top meatloaf. That's a little different, isn't it?
Yeah.
Everybody makes a meatloaf different, so we're going to try to make one a little different today.
Let's do it.
Okay. First of all, we must have the hamburger, of course.
Mm-hmm.
About 2 pounds, I think, is here.
Okay.
And then we got the onion, and we put the onion in here.
Right in there. Okay.
Right in there, and
I'll take your dishes.
And then we take the green peppers, of course.
Mm.
We got lots of green peppers.
And colorful.
Yes. And now, let's see. We mix some eggs in here.
Got a couple of raw eggs there.
A couple of raw eggs, and we'll just mix them right down in there.
Okay.
And a cup of bread crumbs here.
Bread crumbs?
Or cracker crumbs, whichever you want to use.
That kind of the glue that holds it all together.
Yeah, that'll mix it. And this is French dressing.
Oh.
I don't know if you've used French dressing in a meatloaf or
no,
not.
No, I have not. That's a new one on me.
It's really, really good in there, and I think that folks will enjoy that very much. And then, of course, you take this and you blend it all.
Okay.
And you mix it, and it's very important that you mix it well.
Okay.
And get all ingredients equally distributed in there.
You know what I'm going to do here, Jimmy?
You're pulling my mama's trick now.
Okay. How about that tomato paste? Is that coming
tomato
in?
Tomato paste, absolutely, it goes in there. You bet it does. Now, you just let me put this in there.
This is kind of exciting.
All right.
Kind of reminds me of the day Dr. Ruth was on the show. It turned me on.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
I think that's about it right there.
So we've got our tomato paste in there.
And you make that into a loaf after you've got it all mixed up and everything.
All right.
And then you place it
in that little pan there?
Place it in this baking pan
or
a baking dish, whichever, and make a loaf out of that.
Okay.
And after you got it all in there, then you put it...
Okay, we'll pretend we've got it all in
just
there.
Just form a loaf, and then we put it... We've preheated the oven.
Yeah, we usually preheat to 350 degrees, right, Ginger?
350 degrees.
That's as far as our oven goes, Jimmy.
Well, that's hot enough for this, and for anything else, I suppose. But you just take this and put it in the oven, and you put it and you bake it now for 1 hour.
1 hour?
1 hour, and then you take it out.
And you take it out and you put it on that. I see we've got a nice cookie sheet over there, one that's already been cooked.
Take it out. And
then what's going to happen over here with our potatoes?
Okay, we take these mashed potatoes. I think there's about 2 cups of mashed potatoes in there. And we put this French dressing in it.
Ooh, more French dressing.
More French dressing.
We have a little egg here.
And we blend an egg in there, too. And then we salt and pepper this over here. I forgot to do that.
Well.
Everybody will know to salt and pepper their own meatloaf.
Yeah, and sometimes people like to salt it to taste.
Everybody in the world's made a meatloaf, but they haven't made one like this.
No, that's a first.
Blend this together.
I'll hold your.
Okay.
Now watch out, Bruce and Terry fool with this one.
Whoops.
He's got it.
May have it too strong there.
On top of the
whoa.
Take an old cold tater and wait, I think.
Cold tater and wait is right.
There we go. Perfect.
Taters have been good to me, Florence.
They sure have.
They really have.
That was a big hit for you, wasn't it?
That was my first recording.
You're kidding.
My first recording was Take an Old Cold Tater and Wait. And folks bought that record and made it successful. And
may the bird of paradise fly up your nose.
My.
That was a big crossover hit
what
for
a
you,
big
right?
Hit. Yeah. Yeah, and then we take this.
Okay, now we've got our potatoes there.
Potatoes and the onion and the egg and the everything, and we take this. And
oh, you're going to put it all around there, I bet.
It around there, and you just make a frosting out of
how
this
wonderful.
Or an icing.
Why don't we put it on this one, Jimmy? The folks, I think, can see it better since that was already cooked.
That's fine. That's
great. Just put a little on there, and you're just going to make like a crust around there?
Yes, ma'am.
Out of the potatoes?
Put it on there evenly, and when that's
baked, this looks wonderful.
Now you put that in there, and you put your stove-on broil on this.
Oh, I see. You're going to brown this.
And you brown it until it's just lightly brown.
Looks like a cake.
It's better than a cake.
But while Jimmy is spreading those wonderful potatoes all around and just making it look so beautiful, I'm going to recap this recipe for you. You're going to really want this one. Okay, here we go. You preheat your oven to 350 degrees, chop your onion and your peppers, mix your beef, a half cup of French dressing, tomato paste, breadcrumbs, onion, bell pepper, 2 eggs, salt and pepper, and then you shape into a loaf, place in pan, and bake that for about an hour. Place your meatloaf on a baking sheet, and then put the remaining egg, you beat that up, and the French dressing into potatoes, and you mix it real well, spread the potatoes over the loaf, and you broil till lightly brown. Now, Jimmy, we've been trying to broil these guys and get them nice and brown. Nothing's happening to them. But Williams and Rhea are going to be here in a minute, and they're going to make sweet potato cake. Hey, so come on back.
Elvis. No one had more raw talent and sex appeal. But for 7 years, he stopped performing live. Then, unexpectedly, he came back, better than ever, to reclaim his throne in what critics and fans agree is one of the greatest rock and roll performances ever. Triumph with Elvis in the 68 Comeback Special, a fine china collector's plate recommended by the Bradford Exchange. Approved by the Elvis Presley Estate, artist Bruce Emmett's portrait captures the king at his best. So to enjoy this extraordinary collector's plate in your home, call this toll-free number now. But act quickly before this limited edition closes. An earlier Elvis plate recommended by the Bradford Exchange, Elvis at the Gates of Graceland, is already trading at over 2.5 times the issue price. Today, the Bradford Exchange recommends the 68 Comeback Special. It's backed by Bradford's unconditional 365-day guarantee, so you risk nothing. To order your plate at the issue price of $24.75, call this toll-free number. The 68 Comeback Special depicts a timeless Elvis performance, a historic moment in rock and roll history that could only come from the king. Out. Call toll-free now. Have your Visa or MasterCard ready to save COD charges.
I would hope that everybody would have a safe and happy holiday and get a chance to spend time with their family and their friends. That's what it's all about.
Guests and stars stay at Clubhouse in Nashville, just minutes from Opryland. Complimentary breakfast and evening receptions make you feel at home. Call 1-800-CLUB-IN.
You know, little Jimmy Dickens has received one of the, I guess, the highest honor that you can receive in country music. You were voted into the Country Music Hall of Fame.
Yes, ma'am.
That, isn't that something?
Thank you. Thank you, folks. I appreciate that. That's a great honor. I was nominated 4 years in a row,
mm-hmm.
And you go with, you know, with the anticipation of going in and you got your speech all prepared, and then when they do call your name,
you don't have it ready.
On the way to that stage, it all goes away, and you get up there and mumble, you know, so. But it was a great honor. You voted into the Country Music Hall of Fame for contributing something mm-hmm. to an industry and that we all love, and voted in by your peers, and it's
well, I
great
think
honor.
That's the great honor, is that your peers do vote you in.
Yes, ma'am.
And so that really counts for a lot. I don't think that these two guys will ever be voted anywhere. You know, it's doubtful if they will win anything in life.
We voted in the Hall of Shame.
Yeah, Bruce and Terry in the Hall of Shame. But, you know, they're wonderful guys. They are funny, and I adore them. And today they're going to make for you sweet potato cake, Williams and Reed.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. Oh, golly gee.
Golly gee.
Yes, indeed, boys and girls. What a thrill to be here with of course, little Jimmy Dickens.
The Dr. Ruth of country music.
Yeah. So to speak. And in honor of that, we are going to do a dessert, of course, sweet potato cake.
Sweet potato cake.
Or as we say on the reservation.
The greasy, creamy thing that makes the deer run towards the headlights.
Yes, and don't you know the deer. We're going to need some ingredients. Now, boys and girls, those ingredients will be as follow. First of all, you will have to have some brown sugar.
Some butter.
And some vanilla.
And 5 eggs.
And some sweet potatoes.
And you'll need unbleached flour.
And you'll need some cinnamon.
Nutmeg.
And ginger.
Baking soda.
And you will also need some baking powder.
Some salt.
And some chopped pecan.
And raisins.
And, of course, you'll need some crushed pineapple.
And prepared coconut pecan frosting. And a huge cart to carry all that
absolutely.
Stuff in.
Absolutely. And first of all, mm-hmm. you preheat your oven to 325 degrees. As you know, our TNN oven is set at 350 degrees.
But
what we do is put a picture of Ralph Emery in there just to chill it down just a little bit. All right. And then we in a bowl, just kidding, Ralph.
Just kidding, Ralph.
Ralph, just kidding.
Ralph!
All right. Now in a butter, we take our softened butter like this.
Yeah.
And we stir it up with our deal on slow speed.
Well, you start to cream it. That's what it's called.
Now you got
creaming.
To put in your powdered sugar.
That's your powdered sugar? That is actually a brown sugar.
Brown sugar,
yeah.
Excuse me.
Brown sugar?
It wasn't even powdered, it was cake.
Yeah, yeah. It's actually sugar and vanilla mixed together, isn't it?
No, here's the vanilla here.
Oh, well now it is. Now it is, by golly.
For once, he's reading the directions. Isn't that amazing?
I sure got lost.
Yes, you did.
Right away.
And then
step two.
Step two.
Yeah.
Step three, we add the eggs.
Oh,
I
yes.
I know that, Ginger. Don't be hollering at us. We add the eggs.
5 eggs. That's enough to turn Bob Barker's hair back. Oh, man. Look at
and
that
same.
Yeah. Oh, good. Good. Oh, it's a little boy named Billy just went by. He's holding up four fingers.
No problem. All right.
Okay.
We've got this baby at it. Now,
now,
we add in the sweet potatoes.
Sweet potatoes.
Now, what are sweet potatoes?
Sweet potatoes? What are sweet potatoes?
What are sweet potatoes, Bruce?
Sweet potato cakes.
Oh, what are sweet potatoes?
Well, what are sweet potato cakes is what our thing is.
All right. Well, Is it A?
Potatoes that are good in the sack, but in a cake, they're not worth a yam.
Is it B?
Is it scallops from the Iroquois?
Mm. Or is it C?
Or is it C, vegetables who aren't afraid to admit that they have peelings?
Oh, golly gee. Well, now we add the flour. We add the unbleached flour.
Oh, the unbleached flour, yes.
Why is it unbleached?
Well, you can't see its roots.
Of course. Of course. I knew there was a good joke there.
Yes. Good heavens. Have you got enough insurance to be having operating equipment
and
like
then,
this? And then you add your flour. You've done that.
I may have to jack this speed up. It's getting a little heavy.
All right. Then let's get the cinnamon in there.
Put the cinnamon in.
The nutmeg.
And the nutmeg.
And then, of course, you're going to add your ginger.
Ginger.
That's not the ginger. That's the nutmeg.
Yes.
And then your baking soda.
And your baking powder.
Baking powder.
And your...
And, of course, your salt.
Yes.
Yeah. And then you mix real well.
That wasn't salt. About 5 pounds of salt.
And then,
not only does he not know how to cook, he's half blind.
I can see Pluto on a clear night.
All right, now
I got a prescription windshield in my car. It's great for me, but the passengers think they've been drinking NyQuil.
I just fired it up. Oh. Just a little bit. Now, we need to put in our raisins.
And our pecans.
And our pecans.
And our pineapple.
And our pineapple. And why do we put the raisins in?
I think the softness of the raisins balances the masculinity of the pecan.
Of course. Oh, what a beautiful delivery.
And let's
that
put
was.
That in there. Let's put that in there, the pineapples, and
yes?
Then I'll just get the bundt cake ready.
Oh!
Ginger already greased our bundt pan.
Oh, there. Yes. How lucky we were to have our bundt already greased.
Oh, really?
Well...
This looks like a garage for that cushion that you always use at games.
Well, yes. You shouldn't tell everything on television.
Oh, okay, sorry.
All right, now we're putting this in, mm-hmm. like this.
Yeah,
and it's just about really... ready, I think.
Oh, you schmalfed it in there.
Just schmalfed it.
And then you stick it in the oven.
Come on, Billy, do this.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Then you stick it in the oven for 60 to 70 minutes or until the cake test's done.
And while that's done, we have time for our commercial.
Yes, it's the little Jimmy Dickens couch tater.
Yes, it is.
There's nothing half-baked about this perfect carbohydrate companion.
Yes.
Who'll only have eyes for you when you take him to the petting zoo, the mm-hmm. library, mm-hmm. or fly on the back of the bird of paradise right up your nose.
Yes, indeed.
Send $9.95 if you want it, $10.95 if you don't, to West by God, Virginia.
Yes.
If you don't, we'll include these bonus accessory hats.
This comes with that one?
This will change his attitude quicker than a Mandrell family reunion.
Yes.
Here's the little Jimmy Dickens model.
Couch tater.
Yes.
And here's the...
And here's the little Daniel Dickens model. And, of course, the current favorite, Robo Dickens.
All right.
Yes. The little Jimmy Dickens couch tater. Remember, this spud's for you.
Oh, yes. Now, it's amazing, but after you bake it, it comes out looking like this.
And you drizzle over the top
and
of the cake.
And you drizzle over the top
here's
of the cake.
You spoon it over
with
the top
this.
Of the
oh,
cake.
You spoon it. That's
yeah,
right.
Right.
We weren't
you
drizzling.
Spoon it over
we're
the
spooning.
Top of the cake. Yes. And while the Indian's doing that, let's recap.
We can recap. Here's what we did, boys and girls.
We preheated the oven to 325. Put the picture of Ralph Emery and creamed the butter and sugar and vanilla.
We added the eggs and mixed well.
And mixed in the sweet potatoes.
And then we added the flour, the cinnamon, nutmeg, ginger, baking soda, and powder, and salt, and mixed well.
And then we fold in the pecans, raisins, and pineapple.
And we spoon batter into greased and floured bundt pan.
Bake for 60 to 70 minutes.
And we cool 10 minutes and turned in a steaming dish.
And high heat the frosting just
and then we spooned over cooled cake. And this is what it looks like.
Now let's pull it on over to the Contralto Corral with the lovely Florence Henderson and our special guest.
I tell you, I bet people are going to be riding in for one of those dolls.
Yeah, you bet.
Yeah, you. We're going to sing a song that Jimmy's been singing since the 50s, right? Who wrote this song, Jimmy?
My friend Boodle O'Brien wrote this song for me because he figured I was so short, every time I pulled my socks up, I blindfolded myself.
Well, you're going to recognize it, so have a ball, clap along, just have fun. Come on, Jimmy.
A lot of folks have told me I was poor before I got ripe. Oh, when a rap will be thumped in the fall. And even as a youngin', I was not the bashful type, 'cause I could yell aloud and stop them all.
I'm little, but I'm loud. I'm poor, but I'm proud. I'm countryfied, and I don't care who knows it. I'm like a baby rooster in a big red rooster crowd. I'm cutie short and little, but I'm loud.
My turn.
I learned to do my singing, walking long behind the crowd. The singing teachers always pass me by. And so I have to sing the only way that I know how. Just rear back, open up, and let her fly. I'm little, but I'm loud. I'm poor, but I'm proud. I'm countryfied, and I don't care who knows it. I'm like a baby rooster
in a big red rooster crowd. I'm pretty short and little, but I'm loud. Take it, Jimmy.
I sang a special solo song in church one Sunday morning, and I was plumb embarrassed to my skin. I hit a high note and well, sure as I was born. Two gals and 14 hogs came walking in.
I'm little, but I'm loud. I'm poor, but I'm proud. I'm country pied and I don't care who knows it. I'm like a fanny rooster in a big red rooster crowd. I'm puny, short and little, but I'm loud. I'm puny, short and little, but I'm loud.
Yeah.
We'll be back in just a minute to take Little Jimmy Dickens Tater Tot Meatloaf. You folks come on back. That was fun.
Wesson's meant the best in frying for 75 years, and it just keeps getting better.
Wesson vegetable oil is my old favorite. All natural, cholesterol-free. That's not exactly old-fashioned.
Wesson corn oil is part of our low-fat, low-cholesterol diet because we're concerned about reducing cholesterol.
Wesson sunflower oil is 89% saturated fat-free. That's right for the way we live.
Wesson vegetable, corn, and sunflower oils. With every bite, you know you're eating right.
You know, Grandpa, there are as many calories in this little chocolate chip cookie as in three whole cups of our light popcorn.
A cookie that small? You hardly know you ate it.
Orville Redenbacher's light microwave popcorn. You can eat a ton of it. You know, Grandpa, for a single gram of fat, you could have three whole cups of our light popcorn. Or some light potato chips.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really. Three of them. Orville Redenbacher's light microwave popcorn.
You can eat a ton of it.
Well, the only problem is my father is not going to let me get my ears pierced. No way. You're right. Jimmy?
Sunlight has real lemon juice.
Personally, I think you should wear the red hair. The one with little blue grape earrings. Oh, they are...
It cuts tough food easily. And leaves everything sunlight clean. In fact, it's so easy, you almost don't have to be there. Sunlight with real lemon juice. We make light work of dishes.
Oh, the Waynes from Bangor, Maine love shrimp with hair cream at linguine. While the Chews from Santa Cruz stir fry their veggies with rotini. It fills them with a feeling that's as good as it can get. That's why America's having a love affair with Cremette.
Cremette, America's pasta, cooks up perfect, doesn't stick, and keeps bringing folks together.
It fills them with a feeling that's as good as it can get. That's why America's having a love affair with Cremette.
What I call the moment of truth, Jimmy. We get to taste your wonderful meatloaf. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful, folks?
Isn't it pretty?
That's the tater tot meatloaf made by Little Jimmy Dickens.
Yes, ma'am. And I hope that folks will try that.
They'll love it.
And they'll enjoy.
Do you still go on the road a lot?
I'm on the road most of the summer.
Are you really?
Yeah, I'm about to wind it up, but I've been on the road all summer long since, well, April, May, and started really working hard in July with the fairs opened, and we've been buzzing around the country.
I think it keeps you young, traveling.
Well,
like
I love
that.
I love being in front of people, and when I'm off a few days, I get jittery. I got to get back out there again.
I'm kind of like that too. You know, I always say when I'm out on the road, oh, it'd be so nice to stay home for a while, and I stay home for a couple of weeks, and I'm going, get me back on the road.
That's right.
But I just worked with Bob Hope in Louisville,
yes,
Kentucky. 87 years old.
Yeah.
And he signed books all afternoon, did an hour show.
Marvelous.
Yeah, and it's a thrill.
Yes, it is.
Well, Jimmy, I know that you're going to want to taste that, and I know that the folks at home are going to want your recipe. I'm going to steal this one. You just write to me, Florence Henderson, care of Country Kitchen, 2806 Opryland Drive, Nashville, Tennessee, 37214. And if you would like this cookbook, and I sure hope you do, I wrote it. There are a lot of wonderful pictures in here. Jim Higgins took them, and we have stories, and here's how you can get it.
For your copy of Florence Henderson's cookbooks and $19.95 plus $3 shipping and handling to Florence's cookbook, 2806 Opryland Drive, Nashville, Tennessee, 37214. MasterCard or Visa customers call 1-800-634-5620. That's 1-800-634-5620. California residents are subject to sales tax.
Jimmy, thank you for coming today. It was an honor.
What a pleasure.
A privilege.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you all
for coming. I appreciate you having me here.
See you next time.
Thank you.
popular country music songstress Reba McEntire gets candid with Laurie Ann Crook on the next Celebrities Offstage.